before we talk about all these, we have to talk about
yes
these things to come up with a story of evolution.
Yes, and we have a presentation about that Stone Age nonsense, which disproves that Stone Age nonsense idea claim, and because we already see in the drawings of the ancient Egypt, in the drawings on the in the in their ancient buildings, we have such drawings, and they use electricity already, just thousands of years than we started to use. And in this presentation, inshallah, let's see the drawings in the walls of the hieroglyphs, inshallah, released in the temple of Hathor at Dendera, have revealed the possibility that ancient Egyptians knew about and used electricity. So electricity existed in ancient Egypt already. And when the figures of this relief are carefully examined, you can see that just like today, high voltage insulation must have been used at the time. So a bulb-like shape is supported by a rectangular pillar called the Djed pillar and assumed to be an insulator. And here another picture about that, the Djed pillar, frequently shown in Egyptian drawings, and we observe these drawings frequently, may symbolize a kind of electrical apparatus. The column may have served as a generator, thus providing lighting, inshallah. Here some other drawings, these electrical cables insulated with bead-like materials, here you see, and there is battery as the power source here, inshallah, this is the battery. And in this picture in the temple of Dendera, on the other hand, there exists four white filaments, a fine wire heated electrically to incandescence in an electrical lamp. So by the wire extending from a giant electric battery seen on the left of the picture, it provides power to these lamps. So here, before the electricity is given, they are dark, but as the electricity is given, then they are bright. And here is the mechanism tells how they work. In the Egyptian wall picture above, it is seen that electric cables connecting the battery to the lamp are covered by beads in rows. Such beads are used for the isolation of the electricity in the cable. So beads are being used. Here you see in this picture, these are the beads being used as isolation. Here again, the beads used as isolation. And here we have the arc lamps. It's the arc lamp, called to be arc lamp, and being used in some projectors already, in some, for example, in the movies, it's being used in the movie, in the cinemas.
The projects
yes.
on the wall. Or
yes.
The curtain.
So in this arc lamp, also as in the case of the ancient Egypt, bead-like materials were used for insulation, as it is being used in this arc lamp. And ancient Egyptians with arc lamps in their hands. We have such pictures, inshallah. These are the arc lamps handled with Egyptians. These are the filaments enabling the transmission of electric current in the bulbs in the hands of Egyptians, as is today. Filaments in the ancient Egypt were also in the form of spirals, and these spiral filaments warming up together with the electric current emitted light. And the first filament lamp discovered by Thomas Edison, here you see the picture of it, in the picture above, is very much similar to the lamps seen in the hands of Egyptians. And in the ancient Egypt, arc lamp technique was used. We can conclude so. So arc lamps produce light by an electric arc between two conductive bars, first touching two bars with opposite poles to one another and then distancing them for a few millimeters, this produces light. Arc lights are 200 times stronger than classical bulbs and they emit very strong and bright light. Which we have with Edison lamps. Because of their intensity, as I mentioned before, these bulbs are used in factories, light therapy, projector lamps and cinema industry. MashaAllah. And this animation here, this is an animation how light is being produced by Egyptians in the past. Shows how the arc lamps in the Dendera temple were used. On the right is the light arc generated by two carbon bars with opposite poles, distancing a bit apart, so the light is being produced, inshallah.
MashaAllah.
A very bright light is being produced. So, the two people on the right and left of this picture hold two metal materials with opposite poles to produce electric current, to get the very bright light, inshallah. So they cannot name to be primitive people, but they invented light, invented that arc light, and they used it in those very dark environments.
Thousands of years ago.
Yes.
Exactly.
So the arc lamp in our day is the type which was used in ancient Egypt. It was just like the same. Here you see a bulb that works on the principle of arc lamp used by Egyptians. This bulb is used in projectors of our day and provides high intensive light when it is needed. Or another example, receiving electricity from car battery. The man in this picture produces a very simple arc lamp by two carbon bars with two opposite poles. The lamps in their hands are also in the form of small hand lamps having their own batteries. So it's not these findings, these pictures, these drawings in the walls by Egyptians. Again, this proves evolution's claim that there was primitiveness, there was ancient people lived in the past, which were devoid of technology. No, they were using technology already thousands of years before, MashaAllah.
MashaAllah.
2000 years before then we invented that Edison lamp, they were already using a much brighter light than we have today.
MashaAllah.